Check. You know what? You know what? I had posted on Facebook and Instagram that I was going to start at 12:30. Because I honestly thought it was going to take a lot longer to set up all of the stuff I got going on today with this new look. Here we go. Let's do it. Let's jump over. With this new look. Yeah, I thought it would take a lot longer to get it all set up and get everything functioning properly. And so I said 12:30. And then I was sitting here at 11:50 like, oh, I could go in like 10 minutes. All I got to do is hit live. So, yeah. If you're watching this back because you tuned in at 12:30 and you were like, damn, this thing's already halfway done. That's why, guys. That's why. Ugh. All right, I got to close this door real quick. Hold on. See, I wasn't ready. See? The best laid plans of men and mice or something like that. Well, let me turn this. You're going to see our tight rebarred window, so just give me a second. You might ask, why the fan? Well, we haven't finished the roof here in this room yet. So when the door closes, no AC gets in. And it gets fucking hot. It gets super fucking hot. So I got to position myself here so the light stops adjusting. But yeah, check it out. I was told by my friend Raquel, who streams on Twitch. Raquel Lilly, if you haven't checked her out, you should check her out. She's super fucking talented. She sings songs and takes requests. And does shows all around the country because she's fucking talented. She fucking went to school to be a vet and then was like, fuck it. You know what? I'm going to make music. So, like, her fallback plan is to be a vet and makes, like, silly cheese. Yeah, she went to UC Berkeley. She's, like, super smart. And then she's also now, like, super kind of famous on Twitch. So, yeah, she told me, you need to get a ring light. That's why you can see the little fucking ring in my eye. It's not because I watched The Ring and in 7 days I'm going to die. It's because she told me to get the ring light. Because a lot of people told me, hey, man, it's hard to see. It's a little dark sometimes on the little podcast, on the little stream. It's hard to see you, bud. Could you maybe fix that? And so I went and got a circle light, a ring light. It's bright. I'm more attracted to the lights. I feel like a fucking moth. I want to look at the lights instead of the camera. I just want to look at the lights. There's so many lights. And then I want to look at myself on the screen behind the camera because now you can see all of my imperfections perfectly. My slightly yellow teeth, my Mexi stash, my patchy cheek beard, my unibrow. You can see it all. The bags, the super tight bags under my eyes. You can see that too. So yeah, thanks a lot, guys. Now I look like fucking trash. Gotta do makeup now before I fucking do a stupid podcast. There's a rant. Why'd I gotta do fucking makeup for my stupid podcast? Oh, need some inspiration. Anyways, before we jump into the topics today, which if you don't know what the topics are because you didn't see them on Facebook and you don't follow me on Instagram, here are the topics. Hey, Jordan, have the fucking notepad open so everything moves fucking smoothly. All right, here's the topics. We're going to talk about the Facebook thumbs up, the one that comes in the messenger. That's a fucking thing. Fuck. I got a good one on that, okay? Listen, I got a lot to say to Facebook about that. We're going to talk about lies in 90s television. TV's telling you lies. Wake up, folks. Then we're going to talk about here comes fucking baseball. Here it comes, folks. If you don't like sports, you definitely don't like baseball. Is it even a sport? We'll talk about it. We'll talk about my mom roasting dating profiles. Okay. And last but not least, since yesterday was Valentine's Day, I have a very special Valentine's Day Uber tale. Shit was wild. It was honestly wild. Yeah, happy Valentine's Day, everyone. Did you go out with your loved one? Did you just start dating someone a week ago because if you had a fear that you wouldn't get anything on Valentine's Day? Did you hit up your ex, say happy Valentine's Day, hoping they'd hit you back with the same and you could convince yourself somehow, some way you actually had a Valentine? How was your Valentine's Day? What did I do on Valentine's Day? Well, if you listen to the song that started out the podcast in the intro scene, I made that on Valentine's Day. Happy fucking Valentine's Day to me. Music and reggae has never let me down. It has never let me down. Like the plethora of women that I've dated in my life, reggae has always made sure that I'm happy and uplifted. So, oh look, if I sit back a little bit, normally, not so much into the fucking light, I actually kind of look like a tan Donald, like the tan that Donald Trump has. Very nice. Maybe I should adjust this and just hit it with a little, oh! Ooh, that's nice. Now I am as pale as I probably am. That's a good shade right there. All right. We're back. Acoustics rants. I'm just going to talk to myself in this room at the zoo, which, you know, there's a fucking segue. Nice transition, Acoustics. Yeah, so here in the zoo, we've actually pimped out the room out there. We're looking to do live shows very soon. We got to finish up a couple of little things. We're making light boxes now. My homie made a light box. Props to my homie. It was pretty tight. He sought out the letter, the word zoo. But yeah, come through the store, shop, shopdrew.com. Follow us on Instagram, Drew1963. And yeah, that's it. Oh, it's getting a little jumpy there. The frame rate's going all over the place. But yeah, that's it. So come through the zoo. And if you want to come on the stream and rock out, make beats, DJ live, you have a band that wants to play, come through. We actually have a whole new interface that can hook up more than four inputs. So yeah, we're ready to do whatever the fuck. So come on through. And of course, we have a recording studio, so you can come through and check that out as well. Anyways, let's get into it. The first topic of the day is the Facebook thumbs up. You know what this thing is? You go in your Messenger. First of all, the Messenger app. I know they're using it to track me. They're recording all my information. They're selling it to the government. They're selling all my data. But God damn it, I have to talk to my friends. And they won't respond to texts. And I will never call a person because that's weird. Why would I ever call you? That's so aggressive. Don't ever call me. Seriously, just text me or send me a Facebook message. Please do not call me. I will not answer the goddamn phone. That's too awkward, man. I don't want to hear your stupid voice. I don't want to be put on the spot. I want time to digest what the fuck it is you're saying to me and come up with the proper response. In the moment, you might invite me to do something, and I'm probably going to say yes because I just feel bad. But really, I want to say, fuck that. I don't really want to do that. And now you're going to put me in the awkward position where I'm going to have to ditch your ass and I'm going to have to ghost you when it comes time. Hey, Jordan, remember we're going to the Reyes game at 7:30? Ghosted. Ghosted till the next day at 8 a.m. I've seen your text. I actually looked at it like 3 or 4 times. Ghosted. Just ghosted. You called? Ghosted. Not answering. Not calling back. Just ghosted. You left the voicemail? Ghosted. Next day, oh man, sorry, I fell asleep at 5 in the afternoon. Didn't wake up till now at 10. Slept 17 hours. It was amazing. Been sleep deprived, hence the bags under my eyes. Yeah, bro. Totally didn't see your call. Totally didn't see your text. Oh my God, fucking forgot. The Rays game was tonight. We were supposed to go. Yeah, right, I've been planning this. Ghosting? Since you invited me, text me, man. Send me a Facebook message, bro. I don't got the time, bro. Unless it's really important. In the moment, shit. Ding, 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 ding. Yo, what's up, man? Scarlett Johansson is running naked down Central Avenue. You have to come. That's a phone call. That's a phone call. Ring, ring, ring. Hey, we're going to get drinks. That's a text. Or a Facebook message. But yeah, so Facebook Messenger. Yeah, they're stealing all my data. I get it. But I got to talk to my friends, right? But they have this thing that they added recently. You know, Facebook wants to be all interactive and, you know, here's some reactions to statuses. You can't just like it now. You can be angry or happy or crying or wow. And also, we're going to put a fucking thumbs up in the chat right next to the send button, right next to where you exit out, so that when you fucking go to send a message or exit out, you send someone a fucking passive-aggressive thumbs up. It's literally the worst. Happens all the time. It's only there, the thumbs up, to let people know that you read their shit and not just leave them on read. Because people don't like to get left on read. Send someone a message and they saw it and they read it. Why didn't they respond? Some messages don't need a response, but then Facebook realized, oh, do you want to ignore people in the most passive-aggressive way ever? here, here's a thumb. Just send them a thumbs up. Like, hey, bro, you want to go to the mall? Thumbs up. Is imagine talking to someone in person, like you telling them, yeah, bro, I just broke up with my girlfriend. I don't know what to do, man. I want to let you know that. I hope we hang out soon and have a good time. Just hit me up sometime. And then rather than just nodding your head and be like, okay, just like the worst. The worst, and it always, you know, you're going, oh, I'm sending a message. I hit send, and now I've sent a fucking thumbs up. Now I got to explain myself. Hey, dude, yeah, I sent a thumbs up. I didn't mean to. It's not supposed to be there. Now I've had to send another message, Facebook, to explain this fucking thumbs up. And on top of that, because this just happened to me, if you go to remove it before someone reads it, because you can do that now, you can remove messages. Oh, hey, Facebook. Tight that you let me remove messages, but could you please not let the person know that I removed a message? There's a reason why I removed a message. Now they want to know. I was talking to my friend. We're having a great conversation on Facebook Messenger, going back and forth. We're a power to the proletariat. Fuck the establishment, blah, blah, blah. As they're reading it, like, you know, the establishment's just taking that data and reading it and then marking our houses on a GPS map. Here are the drone bombing sites. Yeah, fuck the power of the proletariat, fuck the establishment, the bourgeoisie must collapse, eat the rich, blah, 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 send, hit the thumb, sent the thumbs up. Notice he wasn't present at the moment, he wasn't going to read it, so I erased the thumbs up. Goodbye, thumbs up, don't need you anymore. See ya. And then he's like, hey, what message did you remove? I see you removed a message. Oh, really? This is even worse than just sending a thumbs up. Now I'm going to tell you that I sent a thumbs up. Not even send a thumbs up. I already sent it and I erased it. Now I got to tell you that I send a thumbs up. It's like another fucking step. It's even more passive aggressive than just sending a thumbs. It's like sending a thumbs, removing it. Someone's like, what did you do? And then being like, I sent you a thumbs up. That's the worst. I don't get the point of it. That's my point. Why is there a fucking thumbs up? Can I just say, okay, that wasn't sufficient enough. Now I got to send and I can make it bigger or smaller, whatever the fuck I want to do. That's what I can do. That's really what the fuck's going on. Why the fuck did you put a thumbs up in the goddamn chat? I don't want anything to do with it, man. Just get it the fuck out of here. And hey, if you're going to make me send thumbs up, let me just fucking remove it without telling people that I removed it. What's the point? What's the actual point? What I'm going to tell my love, I love you, and then I realize that's a silly thing to do, and I remove it, and she's like, what did you remove? What's the point? So yeah, Facebook, get rid of the goddamn thumbs up. It's super passive-aggressive. There's no reason for it. Words are sufficient enough to tell people, okay. Okay. Next up on the list, we're going to be talking about lies in 90s television, man, because I started thinking about it. And the TV shows we watch as kids, when we were kids in the 90s, full of a bunch of fucking lies. First of all, spaghetti. Bro, spaghetti? Have you made spaghetti in your adult life? Because it's pretty fucking easy. You get a pot, you put the fucking noodles in the pot with water, you boil the fucking water, you wait just a fucking sufficient amount of time, like 10 minutes of boiling water, and then you have fucking spaghetti noodles. But for some reason, when I was growing up, when I was watching TV shows, making spaghetti was like this fucking, like, impossible task. People were throwing it on the walls to make sure it was sticky, on the fucking ceilings. They were making not fully cooked spaghetti. Everyone was like, fuck, we gotta make spaghetti, holy shit. And they'd cook it on the pot, and then they'd take it out of the pot and throw it on the wall for some fucking weird reason. I've made spaghetti no less than 47 times. Since I have been an adult, and not once have I ever had to throw spaghetti onto the fucking wall. And hey, it's super weird. Haven't fucked up spaghetti yet. Seems to be a pretty simple process. Boil some fucking noodles. So hey, 90s television, what the fuck was that about? No, seriously. What the fuck? Next lie? What? I was under the assumption, I drink coffee, I was under the assumption all of us were going to be hanging out in coffee shops a whole fuck a lot more. Thought we were all going to meet up, get coffee. Thought I was going to date girls. Hey, you want to go get coffee? Sure. Thought we were going to chill at the coffee shop. That doesn't happen. That's not a thing. Hey, Keurig, could you not? People need to go hang out in coffee shops, okay? This is what I told my expectations of life were supposed to be. Hanging out at coffee shops. But no. No, I'm at home drinking coffee by myself. going through the drive-thru at Dunkin' Donuts, fucking playing the radio AM, because I need a voice to listen to feel like I have fucking human companionship. You know what I mean? So what the fuck is that about? Friends? Like Friends? The show Friends? Every other fucking, every show, they're in the coffee shop drinking fucking coffee, hanging on the couch, being friends. Like the show says. Just hanging out, drinking coffee, asking girls on dates. Seinfeld, in the coffee shop all the fucking time. Has the internet destroyed the coffee shop culture? Is this a conspiracy? Is the government trying to stop us from meeting up in coffee shops? To plot the next revolution? To plot the downfall of the government? Is that what's going on? I think it is. Maybe that's the secret, guys. The revolution will not be televised. It'll be in coffee shops. Another lie? How come in 90s television, everyone seems to be, you know, pretty well paid, able to afford rent, has time to get into hijinks, and yeah, just genuinely not seemingly bothered about anything or having any worries. Just day-to-day bullshit that they got to go through. Everyone's got a job. Everyone's fucking paid. Grow up and it's like, yo, real quick, you're going to have to work 77 hours a week to even be able to afford rent. And then if you want to eat, you're going to have to work another 15 hours. You're going to be working 92 hours a week just to try to survive. How does that feel? Oh, you want to hang out with your friends? You don't have friends. You have people that you work with, that you talk to. Those are your friends. What the fuck, 90s television? I was under the assumption that I'd be living pretty comfortably. Me and my friends would be doing crazy shit from time to time that would be, you know, worthy of airing on television. We'd be hanging out in coffee shops and struggling to make spaghetti. That would be the only thing that we had trouble with, is making some fucking spaghetti. But no, now I'm now I gotta worry about the planet fucking melting into itself. Fucking, I gotta worry about, you know, wars and fucking swine flu. I'm not getting paid. Minimum wage is fucking bullshit. No one's paying a livable wage. I gotta pay for the taxes of the rich people, you know. That's why me and my friend were, you know, sending our little Facebook messages, because we realized 90s television, all bullshit. Down. Down with the bourgeoisie. Powers of the proletariat. But yeah, none of that shit in 90s television. Just coffee shop hangouts and fucking everything's wonderful. Like Friends, they're like they don't even show them working. All I know is that Joey's a fucking actor and Ross knows about fucking dinosaurs. They don't seemingly never have any struggles. None. It's all bullshit. And then last but not least, literally no one in 90s television is doing drugs. And that's a lie. Since I've grown up, everyone's doing drugs. Hey, kids, if you're watching, everyone does drugs. Everyone's doing drugs. The television's a lie. On TV, everyone's like, oh, wow, drugs, super bad. In real life, everyone's like, bro, I need drugs. Someone bring me drugs right now. I'm not going to be able to get through this 92-hour work week without drugs. Someone please bring me drugs. Please. They might have a beer, but they're not like pounding shots and fucking going home with random dudes and getting fucking plowed out. Like his real life. Like the teacher on the show isn't like, you know, is this well put together, like nice guy who's giving good advice, not this strung out on cocaine young lady who just graduated from school and realizes that she hates kids. You know? Everyone's doing drugs. Everyone. Mostly cocaine, definitely marijuana, and everyone's abusing alcohol. Everyone. You look around, everyone's fucking on something, bro. Caffeine, it doesn't matter. Everyone's on drugs. I guess that was their drug of choice in 90s television, was caffeine. It's all making sense now. See, this is why I gotta talk this shit out to myself. Because I need to figure it all out. Because I'm just a confused young man wandering the landscape that is the modern world of 2019 with questions. When am I going to go on a coffee shop date? Never. When are me and my friends going to hang out and drink coffee? Never. Why did I think no one was on drugs, but they all are? I don't know. Why was 90s television just one big fucking lie? I don't know. fix that. Let's go back in time and fix that. Yeah, 90s TV is bullshit. Oh, speaking of TV, the only TV shows I watch are sports. Sports are just fucking soap operas for dudes. That's what they are. It's just soap operas for dudes. Don't kid yourself, bro. NFL is just one fucking long soap opera. You tune in every fucking week, fucking every day, 3-4 hours on ESPN, catching up on the fucking stupid storylines and shit. And then there's a fucking grand finale on the weekend, a 7-hour fucking marathon where you sit down and you just fucking stuff your face full of chips and you watch the fucking soap opera. Sports are just a soap opera. Soccer is just one huge soap opera that's never ending. American football, basketball. Oh, where's LeBron going? Oh, Anthony Davis. Where will his eyebrows land next? It's just a soap opera. There's nothing wrong with liking sports. It's just my style of soap opera. But if you're watching sports and you're like, this is important. Fuck, you know, daytime television. I don't even watch Netflix. You know, you're watching soap opera. You're watching male-driven soap opera, so chill out. But the worst soap opera of all? Yo, the worst sport? And it's coming, bros. It's that time of year. The Super Bowl's done. Basketball's winding down. NHL's almost to the playoffs. March Madness is on the horizon. We're just 2 weeks away from March, baby. It's coming. Fucking baseball. It's fucking coming. I'm the most productive during the small sliver of time when it's just baseball on American Sport Television Soap Opera Network. Fucking baseball, man. Bro, they made this game in the 1800s when people literally just hung out in fields and looked at sheep. And then painted it sometimes. They made this, it's a pastoral sport. Because people were just fucking herding sheep and picking up sticks and hitting acorns or some shit. And like, let's run to there and there and back. And that'll be a point. It is literally made for people that have no idea what technology is. That's who it was made for. Baseball was made for people who have never seen technology. They literally were burning whale fucking oil to make light. They had no fucking clue. So what? They'd see this ring light and be like, holy fucking, how much whale oil does that take? Bro, baseball was made for people who thought the car was sent from Satan to ruin horses' lives. Literally, the car was a conspiracy by Satan to ruin horses. That's who watched baseball. Bro, people who watch baseball thought that fucking smoking cigarettes was like eating vegetables, okay? We are so much better than baseball. We don't need this shit. But here it comes. Are you ready for it? Baseball straight down the pipe, baby. Baseball is so boring and so irrelevant that they are now trying to fundamentally change the rules of baseball to make it more exciting. Here's an idea. I need some tackling, okay? I need someone to get fucking hit at some time. Not just the fights every so often when a guy gets pegged. I need decking and tackling to be an integral part of baseball, okay? Also, can we just get like some multiple pitchers and batter situation going on? Multiple balls in play, just fucking chaos. Just make it chaos. If you're going to change it up, just make it chaos. 4 batters, 4 pitchers. They can pitch whenever the fuck they want. And everyone's just fucking swinging, bro. And it's balls in the right field, balls in the infield, fucking guys trying to catch a ball, and the line drives hit at his skull. That would make it interesting. No, let's all stand in position and wait until the ball comes to us. It's cricket. It is American cricket, but it's worse than cricket, in my opinion. Because at least cricket, it's a full circle. No, we took a quadrant of a circle. Oh, a whole circle would just be too much. There's too much going on. I just want 90 degrees of play field. I just want that. And everyone, 9 people, just stand in position and wait. One guy's going to squat and just wait. And then there's going to be this other guy who's going to fucking do a dance choreography routine before every fucking play. Before he throws the fucking ball, and there's like a 1 in like
for like batting average, like 300 is amazing, right? So like 250 is like, I don't know. I assume like 270 is an average. I'm not that into baseball. So like every 1 in 4 at bats, something might happen. Really? There's a fucking play in baseball called a walk. A walk. People want to roast cheerleading. At least they're jumping and spinning and rolling around and shit. Baseball players literally try to get a walk. They try to walk. What kind of fucking sport? You know what? It's a sheep. It's for people who herd sheep. Hey, man. What do you want to do tonight? I don't know. There's no more light after 5 o'clock because we don't have electricity. That's the type of people who watch baseball. That's who baseball was made for. Can we please just move on and get something else? Please. I'd rather watch people play Scrabble. 100%. But yep, here comes baseball. It's hurtling towards you guys. You ready for October? Who cares? Who cares? Baseball has like 2 months to itself, and then it's football in America again. Obviously, I watch soccer, and that's nonstop. It's great. It's wonderful. Soccer is the best sport ever. If you're saying it's boring, you're uncultured, and you don't know what's good for you, you probably don't even eat fruits or vegetables. You'll probably just eat at McDonald's, and your intestines are all fucked up because you don't know what's good for you. Soccer's amazing. The worst sport in the world is baseball, 100%, without a doubt. It was made for people who had a direct connection to the American Revolution. That's who it was made for. So please just fucking stop. No more baseball. That's it. I'm calling for it. We're canceling baseball. Once and for all, this is the year. Baseball's canceled. End the soap opera. We're discontinuing this show. Season finale coming up. Who's going to win? Who fucking cares? But they play 7 games in a perfect... I don't fucking care. The highest thing in baseball is for nothing to happen. It's literally when the pitcher makes sure nothing happens. A perfect game. It's so rare. It's amazing. What happened? Nothing. A guy threw the ball like 27 times. What would be the minimum number of pitches? So it would be 9 pitches an inning, 9 times 81. A guy threw the ball 81 times. What happened, though? Nothing. Just nothing. He just threw the ball 81 times in the same direction. It curved this way one time, and then it just went straight another. And there was a dude squatting with another dude hovering over him. But what happened? Nothing. A guy just threw a rock. A glorified rock. Straight ahead. For 3 hours. It was incredible. I don't get it. What? But what happened? Nothing. That's the highest honor in baseball. The perfect game. It's the perfect game. It's perfect. It's the they're saying that is the highest game of all games there could be. And what does it require? Nothing. Nothing to happen. Not even a walk. Perfect game doesn't even have a fucking walk, bro. There's not even any walking in a perfect game. But this is supposed to be a sport. Cancel this soap opera right now, please. It is fucking ridiculous. I haven't seen a sheep in years since I visited Scotland. Please, can we stop playing this sheep people game? Give it to the fucking Amish. You know, I should only see baseball when I go to a settler community somewhere or like an Amish community. That's where baseball belongs. Next to a fucking self-made wooden barn. And then there's a baseball field. And there's some Amish people churning butter on the sideline because you have enough time to do that. And then they just take like that little stick they use to turn. They take that out and it's their bat and they swing and nothing. And they get a walk and they walk. God, here comes baseball, everyone. Hope you're fucking ready for it. Oh, that felt good. All right, the next one. My mother. This happened yesterday. If you don't know my mom is a 52-year-old widow. She was married to my dad for like 25, 26, something like that, years. I don't fucking know. And then my dad passed away, unfortunately. So my mom is now a widow. And my mom married my father at like 24, right? And so like they were married until she was about 50. And she's not really dated since then. Well, she hasn't dated because she's married. Okay. And when you're married, you don't date. You go on dates with your, you know, with your husband or your wife. Learn a lesson, guys. Don't cheat, okay? But yeah. So she's been married. And since she's been a widow, because it's her first opportunity, she's dating. And unfortunately for my mother, she has to learn how to date in the Tinder, Bumble, Plenty of Fish, Match.com fucking era of dating. And so my mom's point of frame of reference is like, what was it like to date in the 80s? When everyone was going to coffee shops and fucking throwing spaghetti on the wall. Oh, God. So, yeah. She has descended into Bumble. She hasn't been on Tinder. She told me that. She's on Bumble. She's on Match. She's on some other fucking thing. I don't know. 50-year-oldsdate.com or some shit. I don't know what fucking what else she's on. But she told me, she was like, you know, I've been talking to people. First of all, of course, she's my mom. She watched the podcast. Hi, Mom. Hi, Mom. She watches. So, what's up, Mom? But yeah, so my mom was like, I've been telling my dating tales to my girlfriends, and I've been told I should start a podcast. And like, word, I'll help you out, Mom. Totally don't want to listen to that podcast. No, thank you. Don't want to hear your dating tales. No, thanks. You're my fucking mom. Oh, hey, what's up, Raquel? What's up? How's Miami going? I'm just talking about my mom going on fucking Bumble and all these other dating sites trying to get hooked up. My mom ain't trying to find a new husband. She's trying to hook up. She's all about it. So mom's like, I want to do this podcast. I want to tell these stories. And she starts giving me the rundown, right? And she's like, I don't get it with these guys and their dating profiles. They're just shirtless, right? And it doesn't look good. It doesn't look good. These are her words. Like, why are you taking your shirt off to show me that? Yeah, Raquel, you're right. There's nothing wrong with wanting to get fucked. Unless it's my mom, then it's fucking cringy and terrible, and I never want to think about it, and I don't want to record the podcast, okay? Okay, Mom. Okay, Raquel. Is that good enough? Can I just not have to hear that? I get it. How else am I here? My mom and my dad got nasty. I fucking get it. I'm not, you know, I don't have any qualms about it. I'm not fucking, like, you know, disillusioned or, like, thinking that it's... No, I get it. I am sperm and egg, living in the flesh, and that can only happen one way, and that is fucking, and my mom and dad fucked. But I don't have to think about it, and I don't have to record a fucking podcast about it. Okay, Raquel? That's as progressive as I am, is accepting that it happens, and that's it. The first step is acceptance. We'll get to the other ones eventually. Eventually. Anyways. My mom is talking about these dating profiles. Hey, Mike. Hey, Mike, for sure. Don't talk about my mom like that. For sure. I'm looking directly at you. I got the fucking ring light on so you can see my fucking... my face and how angry it is. For sure. For sure, Mike. Chill the fuck out. Or I'm gonna find out about your mom. Yeah. I'll go there. Yeah, Raquel, thanks for telling me I should get this ring light because you can see all my imperfections perfectly. Hey. Yeah, I am young and handsome. I am. Ooh, Mike's mom's hot. Ooh, Mike's mom's hot. Ooh, Mike's mom's hot. Ooh, we should have Mike's mom's on my mom's podcast and they can just hang out and talk about all the... ooh, things that they do. Although Mike's mom's probably not single like my mom, so it could get real weird real quick. But yeah, my mom. My mom's talking about these dating profiles, and I guess like all these older dudes, like 40-year-old dudes and shit, are like, oh shit. Let's get all the moms on the podcast. Let's get Raquel's aunts on the podcast. Let's just get a whole fucking... what are they called? Like a covent of women that we are related to, and they can all talk about dating. Oh my gosh, Raquel, when's the next family reunion? I know that you Asian folk like to get together quite often. I know you do. A harem. Yes, a fucking harem. Yes, all our fucking, all the women in our lives are just fucking whores, aren't they? How else are we born? May they be baptized in the holy waters and their sins be forgiven. I don't know if my mom's considered middle aged, Mike. I don't know. Is 50 middle age? I guess nowadays it is. Everyone's living to be 100. All the kids are doing it. All the kids. Everyone's going to be 100 someday. Please no. Please no. Don't want to shit on myself. That doesn't sound like a good time. I never want to die. I want to die. I want to die the second I shit my pants. The second I shit my pants, that's when I want to die. I use dating sites. I use Tinder usually just to troll people because I can't help it. I'm a fucking troll. It's what I am. So I just fucking troll people. Oh, shit. Shout out to Raquel for hosting the stream. It's fucking tight. Yeah, I go on dating profile. I have a dating profile, dating things. But I just use Tinder to troll because look at me. You see this? I post a picture of me and they're like, holy fuck. This dude doesn't even groom himself. Do I want to allow him anywhere near my vagina? And the honest answer is no. And I'm cool with it. I'm cool with it. I'm not of the age yet where I can really just dive into dating because I am a dad. And there's too many like 27, 28-year-old women out there who have this idea that like I'm going to start my career and get a family and then I'm just going to have my own children. I come with the child already. I bring the family. I bring me to the table. And it kind of ruins the process. And people are like, oh, I wanted to help make the... No, I brought the family, bitch. What are you bringing? You got a tight job? Can I stay at home, play video games and vacuum? Smoke some weed, cook some dinner? Stay at home dad, material right here. Big thumbs up from Facebook Messenger. I did look tight at the engagement party. That's because Kami put my outfit together and grooms me. So that's the only reason I looked any type of, you know, presentable to a woman is because a woman grooms me. And like the only access I have to a woman who would groom me at the in St. Pete is my mom. And that gets weird. Do I want my mom to groom me and have me present myself to the dating world and be like, oh, I'm only attracted to people who find what my mom finds attractive? It's a weird like kind of wormhole that you're diving into there. You know what I mean? But yeah, the reason I look so fly at the engagement party, Raquel, is because Kami did my hair. Cody made me go get shaved. Cody duped me. Cody was like, hey, bro, you want to go get shaved together? And I was like, yeah, whatever, I guess. I personally don't shave that much. I don't know if you can tell. I don't really care too much. I was like, yeah, you know, it sounds tight. And then we show up to the barbershop, and Cody's like, oh, yeah, by the way, my barber isn't here, so I'm not getting shaved. It's just you. BRB, peace. And then I got shaved, and then we went to some fucking consignment store and they got me the tight shirt and then I had jeans and shoes. That's all I brought to the table. And then Kami was like, let me do your hair. And I was like, word. And then Kami did my hair and then I took a picture and I posted that picture on a dating website. Yeah, I was swindled, Mike. I was really upset. I thought we were gonna do some tight man bonding, some brotherhood bonding type shit, get our fucking face hairs cut off together. But no, he had other more important things to do. He couldn't cheat on his barber. He couldn't, and I understand that. I haven't been to a barber in, like, well, other than that one, like, 4 or 5 years. But if I was regularly going to a barber, I would want to, like, have my guy and not cheat on him. You know what I mean? But, yeah, I'm on dating. I'm on dating profiles. I'm on Tinder. I'm on Tinder swiping right. Bumble was a bit of a self-esteem issue. Because on Bumble, the women get to decide. It's the beginning of the matriarchy. Bring on the matriarchy. Let the women decide which men get to procreate. I agree. Fuck the patriarchy. I go on Bumble and I'm like, yeah, hey, tight. You're attractive. Never got matched. Didn't get matched once on Bumble. I was on Bumble active for like 6 months. Didn't get matched once. Not once. There wasn't one single woman that was like, I'll give him a chance. Maybe. Who knows? He could have a good personality. I don't know. He's not really well put together. His kid's cute. Not one single woman was like, yeah, you know what? Not one single. Not one single. And I was like, fuck this app. I feel really shitty about myself. No, the matriarchy is intimidated by this. This intimidates the matriarchy. The matriarchy sees this coming and they're like, oh, fuck. Another 1,000 years of patriarchy is about to come down our barrel. I don't know if I can handle it. Raquel, how do I mod you, bro? I got to go on my Twitch and mod you like right now, like live on the fucking stream. Where's my phone? Where's my phone? Here's my phone. Yeah, so Bumble was, if I type in the message like that, if that's what'll happen. It won't just come up with that exact typing. It'll happen like that. That's what'll happen, bro. And if I mod you, you're going to fucking destroy my shit? Am I going to wake up to like a fucking My Little Pony channel tomorrow? And is that what's going to happen? God damn. Yeah, Bumble was like terrible for me, man. Bumble ruined my self-esteem for like a little bit. And then I was like, no, fuck these bitches. Fuck these bitches. I don't need them. They need me. I don't care. Oh, goodness. Oh, you're going to ban everyone, Raquel? I'm not going to mod you. I might mod you afterwards. We might have to sit down and have a little talk, Raquel, about whether or not I'm going to fucking mod you or not. I feel like this is like a commitment that I don't know if I'm ready to make. And I don't know if you're ready to make. Do you really want to be associated with this? Look, do you really want it? Oh, look at that. A little Mike Herrera emoji. Look at that. Wow. Nice hair, Mike. Nice hair. I like it. I respect the flow. Anyone with the flow, I respect it. 100%. Let it grow. Oh, I can't wait for Raquel to make all the types of shits of me that she possibly can. I really can't wait. Please. Please, Raquel, make emojis like this. Stay young and handsome. Tell the haters the aunties like... I need a panda hand. I need just my hand. Just... Oh, goodness gracious. Oh, but anyways, can I tell you guys about how superficial my mom is, though, on these dating sites? Because the first thing she complained about was... The first thing she complained about was all these dudes were taking shirtless pictures. I guess they don't care. I guess you reach like 40 and you're like, fuck it, this is what I am. And she's like, I don't want to see that. I don't want to see that. If you don't have a hot pod, don't post the pictures. I was like, Hey, Leanne, what the fuck? They're just letting you know what the fuck it is. And you're roasting them. That's why they don't want to date you. It's because they know you're super superficial, Leanne. Get over it. And apparently we can't talk about things we like to do. She's like, oh, all they talk about is fishing and hunting. I don't give a fuck. Okay, well, they're trying to let you know who they are. Get to know you. You know what I mean? Like, how dare they? How dare they let you know who they are? Like, goddamn. Oh, wow. Your mom's a slippery slope. There's Raquel. Ba-dum-ts. It got me thinking. I think 50-year-old dudes on dating websites are basically like 20-year-old girls on dating websites because they do the same thing. Girls on Tinder are like, naked, half naked, bikini photos. I'm sexy. Here's my butt. Dudes, all 50-year-old dudes apparently are like shirtless, just like, look at my hairy chest. You know what I mean? And then like 50-year-old dudes are like, I like to fish and hunt. Every single, I don't know, maybe this is a St. Pete thing. Every single girl on Tinder writes in their goddamn bio, I like to fish. I like to hunt. I'm an outdoorsy girl. Yeah, okay. No. Okay, Tanya. Yeah, I'm sure you fish a whole fuck ton. Yeah, I'm sure you're not just chilling on the boat, drinking beer, smoking weed. No, you're totally out there fishing, Tanya. Oh, goodness gracious. So yeah, my mom's going to do a dating show podcast, guys. How do you guys feel about that? Would you want to tune in and watch my mom talk about her scary, scary dating stories? Apparently, there's a lot of stories. My mom goes on a lot of first dates, and they're all fucking bad. And apparently, it's enough to make a podcast. Tight. I'm glad you guys would tune in. Guess what? I'm going to be filming it, or I'm going to be recording it, because, you know, I got to help my mom's out. You know, she fucking pushed me out of her vaginal canal. It's the least I can do is to record her goddamn podcast. I will just I'll fucking get the sound check right, and then I will plug shit into my ears, and I will not listen. No, I don't want the Cliff Notes. I don't want the Cliff Notes. I'm pretty cool with the Cliff Notes. Don't want the Cliff Notes. Why were you clapping, Mike? I just want to know why you were looking over your shoulder and clapping. I feel like I feel like you're like a dude at a restaurant. What's the guy called? The head guy that like seats you and shit. And like you, like I came into the restaurant and I was like, "Hey, Maitre d'. I don't know. That's so fancy word that I just thought of. Oh, those aren't your hands? Perfect. You look like I came into the restaurant and I was like, "Hey, man, do you have the 1976 Chardonnay from Bordeaux on deck?" And you were like, "We actually do." And then you looked over your shoulder to the dude who gets the wine and you went, "Chop, chop. A choppity chop. Get the 1976 Chardonnay from Bordeaux for a Monsieur Coustiques." Your channel's right. He deserves to be an emote. Yeah, no fapping, please, during my mom's podcast. Please. And if you do, just please don't tell me. What you do inside your own private, you know, circles is what you do in your own private circles. I don't need to know about it. I've been told my mom's hot before. Nee. Mike literally just told me my mom's hot. Nee. Just, you know, do your own thing. Man, who's the guy on the left? Who's Hair God? I don't know who Hair God is, man. Mike, I want you to tell me every time you fap to me, please. It boosts my self-esteem. And honestly, I might get back on Bumble now that you said that. I might get back on Bumble. I can't wait. I can't wait. Oh, man. Raquel, 10%. So that means, like, right now, there's, like, 0.4 people jerking off to me. Oh, goodness gracious. Yeah, Mike, I'm going to say this on the stream. Mike is actually the person that made me think, I just want to grow my hair out. Because I met Mike and I was like, look at that fucking flow, bro. That dude's got some fucking flow, bro. I'm going to grow my hair out. If Mike can do it, I can fucking do it. Other thing that Mike introduced me to, No Quarter by Led Zeppelin. That song, Mike had me and Cody sitting in his dorm room with a black light on his Led Zeppelin fucking poster. And we smoked some weed, and then he played us that song, and we had to stare at the poster. And it's like a 7-minute song. And me and Cody sat there for the whole fucking thing and just stared at it. And then at the end, we looked at each other, and we were like, bro, that was amazing. All we did was smoke weed, listen to a song, and stare at a poster. But it was the way that Mike presented it. He's like, guys, you got to do this. Take a chair. Sit here. Look at the fucking poster with black light. I'm going to turn the lights off. Let's hit this joint. Check it out. Me and Cody passing the joint. Mike's like doing shit. Like Mike's like doing shit. Like moving around, talking to people. And me and Cody are just fucking sat there staring at a black light poster as No Quarter plays. And then it ends, and we're like, bro, can we do that again? Can we do it again? Is there any way you could play that song again? Could you put it on repeat? And the black light, yeah. We're like fucking moths, just staring while the song plays. That was like the first time I met Mike. I was like, this guy knows. This guy fucking knows, bro. He knows the songs. He knows the posters. I think this Mike guy knows, man. I think he knows the secret. And that's why he has hair. I need to grow my hair. And then one time I was hanging out with Mike and I was wearing a hat. And he's like, oh, you going for the hat flip? And I was like, I don't know what that is, but yeah, sure. Oh, you going for the hat flip, bro, with the hair? Yeah, bro. Hat flip. Mm-hmm. If that's cool. Is it cool? Yo, your hair's so tight. Is that cool, Mike? Is the hat flip cool? Okay. Could you play the song again, though? God. Yeah, Mike. What the fuck was that, bro? Oh. I mean, that introduction is just, like, so much better than the first time I met Nevin, though. Because the first time I met Nevin, that was fucking wild. How do I remember this, Mike? Mike, I have a retarded memory. I have a stupid, retarded memory, bro. I can remember like instances that most people probably won't remember, but if I told you stories, you'd be like, yeah, I do fucking remember that. I do remember that. I do remember that, Acoustics. How did you remember that? Cody the other day sent me a story about myself, and I was like, wow, bro, how do you even fucking remember that, bro? Do you remember the holding keggers in the fucking Panther Hall and that one dude, I don't know what his name was, just running down the hallway with the keg, just like into your room? Because I remember that. It was a good memory. I remember it so clearly. It was great. Yeah, the first time I met Nevin, he was barefoot, of course, banging on the door. Me and Cody are chilling in Cody's dorm room listening to some Tight Tech 9, because that's what we did, and there's just like this vicious knocking on the door, and then we answer, and it's just barefoot, shirtless, hairy dude, cigarette in his mouth, just, you guys listening to Tech 9? Yes, we are. Why are you bothering us? We're actually about to put a fucking black light on and stare at the wall for 7 minutes. You want to do it? Yeah, bro, sounds tight. Sounds like a super tight time. The fact that Nevin ended up becoming a lawyer blows my mind. Who would ever hire that man to get them out of trouble? That man is walking trouble. Although maybe now he's more settled down. He got it out of his system in college, so to speak. Oh, God. Yeah, hey, Mike, could you fucking, yeah, do it again, bro? Yeah, plug it into the amplifier. Do it again, bro. Yeah, that guy is representing people in a court of law. That is insane. He's not being represented. If you had to guess, like in 10 years' time, Nevin will be in court. Will he A, be the defendant, or B, the lawyer? Oh, you know how Nevin didn't get kicked out of the dorm rooms? Is because Nevin slept with an RA. He had sex with an RA. Oh, 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 oh. Is that what they're called? RAs again? Is that what they're called? Yeah. What was her name? Rachel? At fucking Reno's, the nastiest, grimiest club in all of Miami. Hey, are you an underage college kid and you want to drink endless amounts of fucking cranberry and vodka before 12 o'clock? Come on down to Reno's. Except if you're in that group of friends that comes together and gets one of you thrown out every fucking week. Every week, someone got thrown out. Not me. I never got thrown out. Hey, here's my secret, guys. A little friend group from college over here hanging out. Here's my secret, guys. Wow. Nevin bled on himself and was in a half-torn polo. What's new, Mike? How about telling something that's not obvious? No shit. Who hasn't bailed him out of jail while he has blood all over himself in a half-torn polo? Old news, bro. Been there. Fucking done that. Next? Hey, next? Hey, fucking next? Yeah, hey, well, you guys were getting all fucking types of just shit-faced in college. I was controlling myself, okay? So I could remember the fucking shit that you guys were doing and then tell you the next day in a concerned parenting way. I'd be like, you guys are like, hey, who can fucking beer bong 3-4 locos? Who can beer bong 3-4 locos? Jordan, you want to? No. No. Okay, Tim, come on. Can you chug 17 4 locos out of the beer bong? We'll just keep pouring them. And I'm sitting there like, this is going to be a fun night. Oh, Cody, you want to get your fucking ear pierced with a belly button piercing, so it looks like a goddamn barbell's in your eyebrow? I'm going to be super upset the whole time you're doing that. And then the next morning, I'm going to scold you like your father. But in 10 years' time, I'm going to tell the story at your fucking wedding. Even though you told me not to, I'm going to tell the story. Cody's like, hey, man, if you tell a speech at my wedding, would you run by some stuff that he... that you're going to say? Oh, for sure, no. I'll tell you what I'm going to say, but I'm not going to run it by you. I'll just give you like a fucking warning. Like, hey, bro, be ready. I'm going to tell the eyebrow ring story. I'm going to tell the exit sign story. I'm going to tell all the stories, bro. Oh, is there a story to be told about Cody? Oh, I'm going to tell it at your wedding, bro. Just be ready for it. Yeah, he was super down for that eyebrow ring, man. I don't understand. I was just like, bro, you're never going to keep it.
No, I want it. I really want it, man.
He was getting down with that Miami South Beach culture and look.
No, man, I really want it.
He's driving in his truck. Raquel, you were there. I forgot you were there. You went upstairs. You were egging him on. Fuck you. I was so tired. I wanted to go to sleep. We were wasting money. There was nothing we could. I just wanted to smoke weed and go to sleep. And I did. I was a passenger in the car. And Cody's like, I should get an eyebrow ring. And I'm like, no, you shouldn't. And Raquel's like, no, bro, it'd be fucking tight. Yeah, bro. Get the fucking eyebrow ring. Weren't you there, Raquel? I think you were. I remember you like being so hyped to like go watch him get his eyebrow pierced. And I was so mad at you. I was so mad at you and everyone else hyping Cody up. Like, yeah, get this eyebrow ring. And we got back to the fucking dorms at like 3 a.m. I went to sleep. I wake up to a call from Cody at like I wake up to a call from Cody at like 11, 12 o'clock. And he's like, bro, what happened last night? Oh, hey, Cody, here's a fucking story. I told you so. Yeah, he kept it in for like 3 days just to spite me because he was like, I can't let Germ be right. I can't let Germ know that he was right. I'm gonna ride it out. And yeah, it was massive. The dude who pierced him was like, hey, we don't have any more eyebrow rings, but we have these fucking tight belly button rings. You wanna fucking wear one of those? Yeah, put a fucking belly button ring in my eyebrow. So it looks like, you know, if I need to fucking lift some weights and pump up my biceps, I can just take it out and fucking lift the barbell a couple times, man. Shit was wild. The other thing that Cody introduced me to was, like, Jack 3D. Oh, yeah, ladies would love Germ. Yeah, oh, hey, you want to date a guy called Germ? Hey, here's a story. Why are you called Germ? Do you really want to know? Do you want to know? It's actually not that serious. It's really not that serious. Yeah, but I'm Germ. I'm going to infect your life. Hey, baby, you looking for a germ? Someone who can work their way into your system and just fuck you up? Yeah, here's what Cody introduced me to. Jack 3D. But not just Jack 3D. Hey, you know what? You're going to go to the gym. You want a little pre-workout pump? How about you take a shot of vodka down the Jack 3D and then smoke a joint? I walk into Cody's apartment. He's like, let's go to the gym, bro. I'm like, okay, cool, tight. Walk in, he's like, hey, man, I got an idea. Me, you, and Mark, we're going to take a shot of vodka, we're going to down the fucking 3 scoops of Jack, and we're going to smoke a joint and go to the gym. I'll say this. I've done some interesting workouts before, but that one was a pretty good one because we just really didn't give a fuck. We were doing, like, push-ups where you put your feet on everyone's back and you make a triangle of people and you do push-ups. We were doing some wild-ass shit, man. And honestly, really good pump. Really good pump. Problem is, Jack 3D is basically methamphetamine. Oh, hey, people around the world just testing positive for methamphetamine but not smoking meth. How does that happen? Oh, I don't know. Maybe it's the Jack 3D. Oh, synthetic meth? Yeah, you should take some synthetic meth and then go to the gym. But also smoke a joint and take a shot. It's a good workout, man. I'm not saying that you should take Jack 3D because it's really bad for you and your heart and everything else. And it's highly addictive. What I am saying is if you want to, on your own fruition, mix that shit with vodka, smoke a joint, and then go to the gym, and then tell me you didn't just have the best workout of your life. Because if you do, you're just a fucking no good liar, okay? And I just don't want to hear it. Leave me the fuck alone, okay? That's it. Just leave me the fuck alone. Can I tell you guys this story? Maybe it's meth. Maybe it's Maybelline. That one got me. I like stupid jokes like that, Mike. It's a stupid joke. I'm not trying to demean you. It's hilarious, but it's stupid. And I like those type of jokes, okay? Can I tell you guys my Valentine's Day Uber story before I wrap this up? It's a really good story. This is the most uncomfortable I've ever been in my Uber in the history of ever, right? It's last night, Valentine's Day. Everyone's getting their fucking groove on, right? All the couples who are about to break up are just giving it one more week. Let's just fucking get this Valentine's. Maybe Valentine's will save us. All the new couples who just started fucking because they were going to be lonely on February 14th, They're all out and about, right? But I pull up to outside, what bar was it? Thirsty First on First Avenue North in St. Petersburg. They make a wonderful grilled cheese. You should check it out if you're ever in the area. So I pick this couple up from Thirsty First. The dude is in like a hairy vest, like a bearskin vest and a t-shirt, which is just a weird ensemble to wear anyways, but whatever. And his, what I assumed afterwards is his longtime girlfriend, given the way that this story goes, his longtime girlfriend is in like a long sequency dress with like the side cut, looking nice. They're both, she's looking great and she's very attractive. He looks like a piece of shit. And what do you know? It played out like that. Get in the car. They sit down. It's, you know, it's very inconspicuous. Your normal Uber ride. They sit down. I have my fresh brewed cup of coffee and they're like, oh, it smells nice in here. It smells like incense and coffee. Well, it's Zumbar. It's a Zumbar sachet. It's not incense. So chill the fuck out. At least it doesn't smell like weed. Was really worried you were about to be like, wow, it smells like weed in here. At least you said coffee and fucking Zumbar sachet. That's tight. We start driving, right? They're having a little conversation. They're getting real flirty, real necky. They're like real touchy. It's Valentine's Day. They've been drinking wine. They've been having dinner, eating aphrodisiacs. It's about to go down, baby. And then this dude says some weird shit. He goes, he's talking to his little boo thing. And then he goes, that's why I'm never going to marry you. And I get uncomfortable. I immediately get uncomfortable. I'm like, holy shit. This dude's like throwing it on the table. And then her mood instantly changes, right? She's like, oh. Right? And then he's like, hey, kiss me. Kiss me. Let's cuddle. Are we going to fuck later? And I'm like, bro, you just told this girl you're never going to marry her on Valentine's Day. Why do you think now she's going to want to kiss and cuddle you or whatever? And he's like, oh, I'm going to have to sleep on the couch tonight again. Wow, you just can't take a joke. Wow, you just don't get me, do you? You don't get me. I'm just making a joke. And she's like, when have I ever hurt you? When have I ever gone out of my way to purposely hurt you? Here I am in the front seat. Thought we were just going to have a normal conversation. Now I've just been edged out of this conversation because obviously I have no part to play in this. I don't know their relationship. I don't know if they should get married or not. I don't know if he should sleep on the couch. I'm just the Uber guy. I turn my music down. Do I awkwardly turn my music back up and try to listen to it? Or would that come off as rude? Would you take that as me saying, shut the fuck up? Now I'm in this weird position. I'm on a 20-minute ride and I got to listen to this relationship slowly dissolve all in an Uber car. When have I ever made fun, gone on my way to make fun of you? Oh, it's just a joke. Get over it. You know you love me. Come on, come here. Give me a kiss. They kiss. I was like, tight. That's cool. They made up. Oh, this ride's going to get better. And then homie goes, he doubles down. Homie doubles down and goes, yeah, if you can't take a joke, I'm definitely not going to marry you. Oh, my God, bro, it's Valentine's Day. Could you save the I'm not going to marry you shit for, like, tomorrow on the 15th? He says it the second time, and she goes, remember that thing I was going to tell you earlier, and I didn't? Well, I'm going to tell you now. Are you ready? And he's like, oh, yeah. Oh, you're going to tell me. I just can't wait to hear. Oh, I just can't wait. This lady unloaded on this dude that she had been sleeping around with three different people, including two of his friends, that she was going to break up with him before Valentine's Day, but then decided to give it another chance, and that she's actually just been whoring herself out for the last couple of weeks. And guess what? This relationship is over. Still have 10 minutes till we have to get to the goddamn fucking house. They're still in my car. It was literally the worst. The worst. That dude, then the dude said something about he could have fucked her friend and he didn't, and it was just really, really bad. And then right before we pull up to the house, the dude goes, well, at least we can both agree we like the smell of coffee. And they got out of my car and they didn't tip, so fuck those people. Fuck those people. How dare you put me in that awkward fucking situation? And then not even tip. God damn it. Give me something. That was the most awkward 20 minutes of my life. Now I know all about your fucking relationship. I don't even know your names. I don't even remember the guy's name. I think it started with like a B or some shit. It was like Brian. And he was in a bearskin fucking... He was a bearskin vest with a t-shirt on underneath. It was outrageous. My worst Valentine's story. It's funny because I do a really good job at avoiding being in relationships on Valentine's Day. Oh, God. Oh, thanks. Thank you. Yeah, it was a wonderful Valentine's Day. There was so many couples that just hated each other in my Uber last night. I was like, man, y'all just really wanted to do this Valentine's Day thing. Like, it was really that important to you guys to go out to dinner with each other. Like, you couldn't stomach the idea of maybe just doing something else, like treating it like a normal day. Yesterday, I knew it was Valentine's Day, but, like, I was in here, like, chopping up reggae, like, samples and, like, you know, I made, like, a Ika Mouse remix. Check it out. Go to my SoundCloud. Check it out. Let me know if it's shitty or not because I just started, okay? I just started. I need all the constructive criticism I can get. But, yeah, I was just chopping up reggae samples and then, like, yeah, I went and Ubered and, yeah, it's Valentine's Day, but it's just, like, another day. But y'all people really needed to go out to dinner with each other and get each other cards and shit. You held on to that relationship for, like, another week. Trying to get something out of it, huh? That's like my sister was dating this dude up in D.C., and brought him down for Christmas or whatever. And they had, like, gone through a rough patch. Yeah, Raquel, we might go Freestyle Friday a little later today. I might actually jump up with the DJ set and chop up reggae samples live and freestyle to that because I just started doing that yesterday, and it's kind of tight. But I'm thinking, like, a little later on, we probably might get a little Freestyle Friday session going up here in the zoo, in the new improved zoo, and you can see all the wonderfulness of it. In fact, when this stream ends, I'm going to turn the camera around so y'all can see the tight room with the tight lights. We got lights, and it's fucking tight. It's like a club in here now. It's like a real-ass club. But yeah, my sister was dating this dude, brought him down for Christmas. And, my sister's like, did you get him anything? I'm like, no, you're not going to be dating this dude. But this dude bought my mom, like, a laptop, and he bought my sister, like, all this expensive shit. And then, like, a week after Christmas, she found out he was, like, a consistent liar. Just lied about where he worked, lied about what he was doing, lied about how much money he made. Just lied about everything, right? And I was like, damn, I should have gotten something out of that dude. He got my mom a laptop. He got Lindsay all his tight shit. I should have asked for something, man. Just something. Something of value. Something of substance. Just something that I could have gotten out of this shitty relationship. But I didn't get anything. I didn't get anything before he got kicked to the curb. But yeah, Raquel, we'll probably do some Freestyle Friday later. We probably will. Hanging out in the zoo. Freestyle Friday ended up. I've just started DJing. Maybe I'll drop the tight reggae funks. Oh, gosh. Thanks for coming and hanging out with me, guys. This is kind of like the vision I had of when I started this. What it has been, because we're getting the channel up and running, you know? It has been me, like, talking to myself in a room for, like, an hour at a time. But I like this better. You guys come in, we hang out, we talk a little bit, you throw some shit down my pipeline, you talk about masturbating to my mom, and it's great. Wonderful time for everyone. Oh! Hey, Raquel, when's your, did you already have your show last night, or is it tonight? When's your show, Raquel? When is your show? Are you going to be streaming the show? Of course you are. Would you like a plug? Of course. Oh, it's tomorrow night. Cool. Where is it at? Is it at Churchill's? No. I remember seeing it. You'll be streaming it. I love a good strim. Strimbone. I eat a strimbone steak every night while I play the strombone. Tea and poets. Those are two things that go together. Tea and poets. Poet-y. It's like poetry without the R. I'm fucking clever. Hey, I'm a rapper, guys. Wordplay is kind of my thing. It's kind of my thing. Ooh, I feel good. You know, you wake up on a Friday, you do a little work, and then you turn on the camera, and you just rant into the camera, and you don't feel so alone anymore, and all the problems come out, and you fix them, and you feel better. We talked about my mom's possible podcast, which I'll have to record. I'm not excited about it. We talked about the passive-aggressive Facebook thumbs up. Facebook thumbs up. Why is it even there? We talked about baseball because it's the fucking worst. It's a sport made for people that are fucking closer to the Industrial Revolution than they are to the moon landing. Can we just get rid of it? Sorry, Mike. I know you played it, but it fucking sucks. And yeah. We talked about the Valentine's Day story, and that was all the things I wanted to get off my mind, guys. Thanks, Raquel. Thanks for stopping by, Raquel. Thanks for hosting me, Raquel. I really appreciate it. Shout out to No SB Mike. Shout out to the most felonious monkey. Even though he said he masturbated to my mom and to me. And shout out to Raquel Lilly, who is the most famous person that I know. She's also the most talented veterinarian that I know. who hasn't, Raquel? Me. I haven't. There's one. My sister. There's two. My grandma. There's three. My cousins, hopefully. There's 11. 12. 11. My daughter, 12. Mic dropping this bitch. Anyways, yeah. So later on tonight, I'm probably going to try to set up a Freestyle Friday. Quans is actually in here with Hyella. And I think Quans might be trying to jump up on the stream to make beats. If he's not, I might even just jump on here because I ain't got shit to do today, bro. It's Friday. Bro, I ain't got shit to do today. But work a little bit later, like at 4 o'clock. So I might start chopping up samples here in a little bit. Maybe I'll jump on the stream and do that. Maybe I will. Chop up some reggae samples live. Or maybe Hyella and Quans will come in here. I don't know. All I know is I'm about done with sitting in this chair. Okay? I'm about done with it. Okay? Yeah. I'm going to go find Quans. See if he's still here. Because they came in and they saw me talking and they had this like disappointed look on their face. Like, oh, why is he doing this right now? Oh, no one even likes this. Oh. So I'll go see what's up with that. Oh, what's up, Russia? I'm in St. Petersburg, Florida. And I know there's a St. Petersburg in Russia. So we're kind of brothers. Or sister cities. Oh, yeah, let me show you the room, Raquel. Oh, God, I got to fucking maneuver this thing real quick. Hold on. I'm going to manhandle this fucking thing. Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh, my God, technology these days. Oh, my God. Yeah, check me out, Raquel. Check me out. Oh! I don't know if you can see it even out there. No, you can't really see. But we got tight lights. Yeah, I can't. The cord's not long enough. But yeah, we moved everything out of that room. Here, maybe if I put it like directly on. Oh yeah, now you can see. That's the new room. There's the DJ booth back there. We got tight lights. We got the speaker set up. We still have the stripper pole. That's the stage, Raquel, you're going to come rock on. And this is the sound booth. And then we have a tight... Oh, can I get it to stretch over here? I don't think I can. But out there, you can... kind of see it. That's our soundboard, and we got a tight fucking Behringer interface with the mixing board on it and like the reverb effects on the vocals and shit, so we can actually stream some real fucking live ass shows. Oh, there we go. God damn. And then we go back to the ring light, and look, there's my tight chair, and there's a fucking window with bars on it, and then I sit down and I'm like, oh hey, we're back live. Yeah, Mike, we have the tight setup now. Maybe, like, in a couple years, I can even, like, you know, hire you or some shit to come and run some sound for us sometime. That'd be tight, right? Or, in other news, I can bring it all with me to Boulder, Colorado, baby. Oh, yeah. Hey, let's... Everyone, real quick, just at home, if you're sitting there, real quick, just tweak the knobs like this. Tweak the knobs. And listen to the sound. That's what the head motion is, okay? Everyone, practice. Ready? This is how you tweak the knobs. Tweak the knobs. And listen to the sound. Okay, good job, guys. Well done, well done. Yeah, this has been Acoustics Rants. Give me like 20 minutes, bro. Oh, I'm going to check you out. Yeah, you have to. Raquel, you have to make this face. This is taking in the sound face. Because the sound is so amazing while you tweak it. That's what you got to do. Everyone at home, please. We're going to do it again. Practice tweaking the knobs. Ready?
Oh, yeah. That's good sound. Oh, that's good sound.
I'm trying to think what else. That's it. Yeah, I'm either going to jump up real quick here and do some reggae samples. Or tweak the sound. Chop some reggae samples. We'll get Quans up in here making some beats, maybe High Yellow rapping. Planning a Freestyle Friday type fucking thing probably around 8 o'clock. So, until next time, this is the Zoo Twitch. If you're in St. Pete, which I think none of you are, come through the shop. We got a shop on the other side. If you're not in St. Pete, shop at zoodaru.com, Z-H-U-D-A-R-U, or follow us on Instagram, zoodaru1963, Z-H-U-D-A-R-U1963. I got the tight black hoodie on. Yeah, it's good stuff. We got the Canimal backpacks. We got Canimal hats, Canimal t-shirts. We got the Blood Fire Land hats. We got the Blood Fire Land t-shirts. We got the five-panel Zoo Army hat. The backpacks, like I said, we have new stuff coming through soon. We got jackets. We got hoodies. We got sweatpants. We got sweat shorts. Check us out. We got skateboard decks, too. What? Skateboard decks with the Canimals on them. Pretty tight. Plenty more stuff to come in the new year 2019. I'm going to hop off this real quick and change the whole setup, and we're going to get after it. Thanks, Raquel, again. Maybe I'll be back on in like 20 minutes or whatever, and you can come back in and check it out. But until then, yeah, that's it. I feel good. I talked it all out. My friends came and hang out with me, and we had a good talk. We reminisced. We walked down memory lane. We stared at the Led Zeppelin poster with the black light while tweaking the knobs. Oh, thank you for the follow, Pharmacept. Thank you very much. Yeah, don't turn on the black light on my sheets, though, because that'll be real, real gross. Yeah, no quarter, on 11, on a guitar amp, not a normal speaker. Plug that shit into a guitar amp, we all know. And yeah, guys, I might be right back, I might not. If I am, I'll see you then, hopefully, maybe, maybe not, maybe you got some shit to do. And yeah, that's been it. Thank you for tuning in to the Zoo Twitch. Tweak the knobs, hey, tweak the knobs. Keep tweaking the knobs in the new year. Just tweak it, tweak the knobs.